Hello everyone, in this video I want to show you how to set up Dual Wan for redundancy on your Asus router. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. If you find the content of my channel interesting, please take a moment to subscribe. It is free, it only takes a second, and it will help my channel greatly. So what is WAN redundancy? WAN redundancy means that you connect two internet connections from two ISPs to your router so that if one of the internet service providers or ISPs fail, the other one will take over, and this way you will have continuous internet access. I'm going to show you the requirements to do this, how to connect everything, and how to set up the router to achieve this, and then I'm going to be testing it also on my Windows 11 PC, so to demonstrate it to you. In my example, I'm using the Asus router RTAX3000, but the instructions I'm going to show you apply to all Asus routers that support Dual WAN. So what are the requirements to achieve this? We already talked about the router. So of course you need a router that supports Dual WAN, and also you need two internet connections from two different ISPs. So why two different ISPs? It is because if you take two internet connections from the same internet service provider and this ISP has a problem, most likely both internet connections will be affected. So it's always better to diverse this and take two internet connections from two different ISPs. The setup that I have here is that I have my Asus router connected to my main ISP with a cable modem, and I want to add internet connection resiliency to this setup. What I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna connect my smartphone that has a data plan with my cell provider to my Asus router. And to do this, I'm going to use USB tethering. This is an Android phone, but the instructions I'm going to show you will also apply to iPhone. What you need to connect your smartphone to your Asus router is USB-C to USB-A cable. Get a cable of a good quality. I'm going to leave a link in the description for a recommended cable. So connect the USB-C port to your smartphone, and then the USB-A port on your Asus router. Here on the back, it has a USB connection, so just connect it to it. So this is the connection made. And now I'm going to show you on the smartphone what you need to do to enable USB tethering. Go to settings on your Android phone, and then tap on connections, and then scroll until you find something called mobile hotspot and tethering. Tap on it, and toggle USB tethering to on. So this way, you are sharing now the internet connection of your smartphone with your router. The next step is to set up Dual WAN on your Asus router. So I'm going to switch to screen recording to go into my Asus router's admin page to show you how to do this. So now we are in the admin page of the Asus router. On the left, scroll until you find something called WAN. Click on it. And here you have something called Dual WAN. So click on the Dual WAN tab, and you need to enable it. So the first thing you need to do, click on this one to toggle it to on. And here the router will ask you, what is the primary one and what is the secondary one? In our case, the primary is WAN. It means that it is the cable that is connected to the WAN port on your Asus router. And this is the blue port on your Asus router. And for secondary WAN, we have the USB connection. You can also choose an Ethernet LAN connection in case you have another ISP using like a cable modem. So all you have to do is you click on Ethernet here and choose the port to which you connected your ISPs, the second ISP. But here for me, it is USB. For Dual WAN mode, you have two modes. It comes by default on failover. It means that if one of the internet connections fail, the router will switch automatically to the second connection. And the second mode is load balance. So what does load balance mean? Load balance means that the router will distribute the internet connections among the primary and the secondary internet connection. So here it is 3-to-1. It means each three connections to the main ISP, you'll have one connection going to the secondary ISP. But here in my example, I will not be using load balancing. I'm going to be using failover, so to show you how the internet connection will be resilient. So when you choose failover, if allow failback is not checked, check it. So this way, if the primary internet connection is restored, the router will fail back to this primary connection. And let's scroll down to continue the settings of this failover setup. So detect interval, it means each 3 seconds, the router will go and detect if the connection is still alive. And the failover trigger, it means that after the router checks 2 times here that the main connection is not working anymore, it will fail over to the secondary connection. And this value is good for me here. And the failback trigger, it means that the router, if it detects two times here that the primary connection was restored, it will fail back from the secondary connection to the primary connection. So I'm going to keep it at 2 also here. And for the router to be able to detect if the internet connection is working, you need to specify a network monitoring type. So here I'm going to specify both. So I'm going to check ping. The ping target is to tell the router what site to ping. So here you have some choices. I'm going to keep it on Google. And for DNS query, it will give you the option here for Microsoft to resolve the query. So this here is also an added way for the router to know if the internet connection is working. So here all you have to do is click on apply and the router will reboot. So click on OK and wait for it to reboot. So now the router rebooted and the configuration should be active. So I'm going to test it and demonstrate it to you on my Windows 11 PC. So now I'm going to switch to my Windows 11 PC and this is a browser open. I'm going to put what is my IP in the browser and it should return my main IP. So I know now that this is my main IP. It starts with 104. And now what I'm going to do is that I'm going to disconnect the router from my main internet service provider. And we are going to wait a little bit and then we are going to refresh the page to see if the IP will change. So this is my Asus router. I'm going to disconnect it now. So here it is disconnected. And now it should fail over to the internet connection on my cell phone. We're going to give it a little bit of time here. And now let me refresh the page. It should be connected now to the failover connection. And you notice that the IP changed and it starts now with 67. And I know that this is the IP of my cell phone provider. So that was it for this video. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. In case you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this way you will not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. I want to thank you all for watching, and see you in the next video.